Assalamu alaikum everyone. Hey guys, I am Shahul Ayan and you're watching Shahul Ayan Vlogs. I am a second year physiotherapy student studying in Narayana Rudralya Institute of Physiotherapy, Bangalore. In this video today, we'll be discussing about the important questions required for your first year physiotherapy examinations, that is the anatomy examination. As you guys know, anatomy is very important for you guys, and anatomy is the base of all the medical studies. So if you don't know proper anatomy and if you don't pass anatomy, you will not be going to the next level. So I have here important questions which my teachers provided during my examination, and it was very helpful. So I'm going to be discussing with you guys the volume wise questions. So first I'll be discussing the upper limb, then the lower limb, then the head and neck, and then I'll be coming to the neuroanatomy. So let's start the video. So first we'll be discussing about the upper limb questions. So I suggest you guys take your anatomy book and, you know, open your first page where the contents are there, and then you can, you know, keep on marking as we guys move on. So yeah, the first one will be pectoral major muscle. The next will be the upper and the lower end of humerus, which is important. Then next will be winging of scapula, then comes the mammary glands, then we'll have axilla, then the axillary artery, then we'll have the cubital fossa, then we'll have anatomical snuff box, then we'll have the superficial and deep palmar arches, then we have superficial veins of upper limb, palmar spaces, axillary nerve, then we have intermuscular spaces, brachial plexus with clinicals is very important, deltoid muscle, it'll come for 5 marks, rotator cuff muscles, and you know the rotator cuff, coracobrachialis muscle, and biceps and triceps muscles. Then the nerves will be radial nerve, median nerve, and the ulnar nerve. Then we'll have the joints, which will be the shoulder, wrist, radial nerve. In the wrist, we'll have the first carpometacarpal joint, and also the flexor and the extensor retinaculums. So this is about the upper limb. Now, moving on to the thorax region. So in the thorax region, you'll have to learn about the first rib, the structure, and you know the joint articulations. And next we'll have the sternal angle. Next we'll have intercostal muscles, and then the intercostal nerves. We'll have then the ascites vein, pleural recesses, lung is for 10 marks, including the bronchopulmonary segments. Then we'll have the right atrium, left ventricle, and blood supply of heart under the heart, and we'll have superior vena cava, thoracic duct, fetal circulation, mediastinum, sinuses of pericardium. Fetal circulation is of less importance, but it is important. So yeah, this is the thorax region. Hey. Hi. So next will be the lower limb. Lower limb, you'll have to learn the osteology of the bones, all the bones. So we'll go by the first femoral triangle, femoral canal, and the femoral sheath. Then we'll have the quadriceps femoris muscle, which is important, adductor canal, gluteus maximus, medius, and minimus, popliteal fossa, the boundaries and the contents, sciatic nerve, tibial nerve, the gastrocnemius and soleus muscle, the hip and the knee joint, and the arches of foot. So these are the important topics in the lower limb. And then we'll move on to, you know, the abdomen region. Yes. So the abdomen region will have muscles of the anterior abdominal wall. That will be the external oblique, internal oblique, transversus abdominis, rectus abdominis. Next we'll have inguinal ligament, inguinal canal, rectus sheath and its contents, the testis, stomach. So all the organs, you will have to write the location, the shape, the size, the external features, the structures, blood and nerve supply, applied anatomy. Structures related to the organs and applied anatomy. Then we'll have, after stomach, we'll have portal vein, liver, pancreas, anal canal, kidney, urinary bladder, diaphragm muscle, psoas major and iliacus muscle, uterus and supports of uterus. Supports of uterus is very, 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 very important. So supports of uterus is very important. So that is the end of the lower limb and the abdomen. Important questions. Hey guys, so moving on to the next volume, that is the head and neck. Head and neck, there are many topics. So I'll be first discussing 7 major important long answers, essay questions. After that, I'll put up a screenshot of the important questions somewhere here or there. So the first will be parotid gland. Parotid gland, you will have to explain the parts, relations, blood supply, nerve supply and applied anatomy. Next will be the TMJ joint. First you will have to explain about what type of joint it is, the ligaments and movements and muscles. Then the applied anatomy. Sorry for the disturbance. Yeah, third will be thyroid gland. Next, you will have to explain parts, relations, blood supply, nerve supply and the applied anatomy. Next, your fourth one will be classifying the dural venous sinuses and describing the cavernous sinus in detail. Fifth one will be describing the origin, extracranial course and the termination of facial nerve. Then sixth question will be describing the tongue. You'll have to describe the parts, muscles, blood supply, lymphatic drainage, nerve supply and adding a note on the development of the tongue. Seventh will be describing the origin, insertion, nerve supply and action of muscles of mastication. Muscles of mastication is very important. So there are 4 muscles. So those are the muscles of mastication. So those are the 7 important long answers according to me. And the rest important topics, I'll be putting up a screenshot here or there. So yeah, that'll be the head and neck part. So moving on to the... So yeah, in neuroanatomy, you will have to learn about the cranial nerves. You'll have to learn all the cranial nerves, but in detail, you'll have to learn about the oculomotor, trigeminal, trochlear nerve, and the facial nerve, and also abducens nerve. So these are the important cranial nerves which you'll have to learn. And after cranial nerves, you'll have to learn about the cerebrum, superolateral surface, medial surface and the corpus callosum. Then in ventricles, you'll have to learn about the lateral ventricle, fourth ventricle with the floor and the roof. Next, you'll have to learn about the cerebrospinal fluid completely. In the brainstem, you'll have to learn about medullas, external and internal structures. And in pons and midbrain, you'll have to learn only about internal structures. And next, you'll have the cerebral and the cerebrum peduncles, which you'll have to learn. Spinal cord and thalamus is, you know, in general, you'll have to learn everything. Then cerebellum, you'll have to learn only about the external features. So this much, I think this sums up the whole neuroanatomy. So if you learn about this much in neuroanatomy and then go write exam, I'm sure you'll definitely pass and ease the exam. So yeah, so this brings us to the end of the video, and I hope you guys like this video and I hope it helped you guys. So if it helped, please share it with your friends so you can help them, unless you are the cheeky bugger who does not want to share things and, you know, wants to do that. But yeah, if you like this video, please like the video, comment down what you need in the next video. I'm thinking of bringing a biomechanics video where I'll share the topics, important topics of our whole biomechanics book. So if you know, if you want that, please comment down. If there are, you know, multiple comments about that, I'll be making a video on that for sure. And then subscribe to Shaholam Vlogs if you haven't already, and click the bell icon for, you know, for the notifications. And yes, that's the end of the video. Thank you for watching Shaholam Vlogs. Keep watching Shaholam Vlogs until then. Bye bye.